Mr. Bridenstine.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And Mr. Kendall, thank you for being here. And General Ramsey, thank you. My question was for you, Mr. Kendall. You mentioned three high-value assets specifically. You talked about Air Force bases, you talked about aircraft carriers, and you talked about space. And that these high-value assets represent a relatively limited number of targets that enable the enemies of our country ultimately to have an advantage when we're on the other side of the world. And certainly that's a concern of mine as well. What I'd like to talk to you specifically about is space. When you think about architectures in space, we currently have in space from the commercial sector literally hundreds of satellites for communications. And if we were to leverage those satellites, we would, in essence, very quickly disaggregate the targeting solutions for our enemies and at the same time create more resiliency and redundancy in space. Additionally, when you look at current acquisitions of, say, WGS satellites and the capabilities of these satellites, we're talking about the ability to transmit 7 gigabits per second compared to what the private sector is putting into space right now, which is, you know, 140 gigabits per second. And that's this year. Next year, we're going to be multiple hundreds of gigabits per second that the private sector is developing and launching. And at the same time, we're going to continue launching into the future, owned and operated by the military satellites that only can produce 7 gigabits per second. My question for you is, when you look at disaggregation and resiliency, when you look at the capabilities of the private sector and you compare that to maybe even, you know, as DARPA was involved in generating or producing the internet. It wasn't until the private sector ultimately got a hold of it and started taking advantage of it for commercial purposes that we actually leveraged it inside the military to where we could actually have an advantage. And if you look at satellite communication architecture, that the systems exist in space now, and it seems to me that we're not taking advantage of it, and if we don't, our enemies possibly could. This, I think, represents a challenge that we have to face as it relates to the acquisition of access to a global communication architecture that already exists in space. My question for you is, as we go forward, will we get proposals from the Department of Defense to take advantage and leverage these assets that already exist and, of course, the rapid advancements in technology that are happening right now?
You make some very good points, and I think the short answer is yes. Because of concerns about survivability of our space assets, we are looking at a wide range of alternatives to the way we currently do business. We have a system called EHF, which sounds like you're familiar with these, which is a very secure communication satellite. And we have to have satellite systems that provide communications that are secure against jamming, secure against cyber attack, and provide encrypted communications for us. And some of those do things like support the strategic deterrent. We also need to have fairly high bandwidth in order to support current operations in certain places. And we have leveraged commercial satellites to some degree, but we are relooking now at our architectures because of the survivability problem that I talked about and that you mentioned, to see if disaggregated architectures of one type or another. And I think one of the things we do have to look at is whether we can effectively disaggregate by reliance more on commercial systems. Now, we have to be sure that they're going to be available to us in wartime, that we'll have the capacity that we need. So there's some questions that we have to answer there. But the short answer to your question is yes. And General Ramsey may want to comment on this because it's largely a requirements question.
And I'll just piggyback on one word that Mr. Kendall mentioned, and it's a great issue to discuss further, and it's disaggregation. This has been a big topic in my 2.5 years in this job, has been how do we look at space as a domain, and it's disaggregation could be doing things that we currently do in space by not doing it in space anymore. So we're looking at the whole soup to nuts. And as Mr. Kendall touched on, the big issue is there are certain things we have to do that are very protected, very secure, that may not have the bandwidth commercial satellites do, but we really are very much wedded to the commercial backbone, and I just see that increasing over time. But it's finding that right balance in the future.
I have about 20 seconds left. Just something to think about. Currently, when I talk to folks in the Pentagon, they talk about buying megahertz. They're talking about buying spectrum. And with spot beams and all the technologies that are advancing today, we need to start talking about, for the taxpayer as well as for the warfighter, we need to start talking about how do we purchase capacity, high throughput capacity, and putting it in terms of dollars per gigabits per second, if that makes sense.